talk about this piece of wood. This is a burl. I'm not sure what kind of burl. We are gonna put some epoxy in it and we're gonna give her a spin on the lathe and see how pretty she looks. She looks like she's got some spalting in it. Yep. And I think I'm hoping to see some burl eyes in it. We'll see. We'll put her in this bucket. We'll put a toothpick. Got a little spot in the center. Try to keep my center. We're gonna go with ocean. Ocean is the color of the day. That's what she looks like on the inside.
Well then, here we go. She's a dog. She's a boo. I do have something to help with that. Flop, flop, flop. Let her slow for a minute. Oh, drip, drip, drip. Gonna put some weights on her. See if this is gonna work. Get back down to where you're supposed to be. Oh, I done lost my... No! You know that stick won't be where it needs to be. Lost my stick. Well, my goodness. I am way over forward. Way over mixed. Way over mixed.
This one I'm going to put some pearl in. Going with the pearl.
Fairly strong, so it kind of stands out. Just give it a stir and see where we're at. Let's give it a swirl. I hate to put too much more in there. Right? I already got that puppy full, full, full. Full, full, full.
It's gonna be a bumpy ride. Yes, sirree. Bumpy ride.
Thank you.
where we're at. First peaks. Let's get some stuff off of some of these cameras. Give her a spin, lady. Well, quite a bit of epoxy soaked right on into that. Right on into it, didn't it? I can tell by the coloring. Let's see, what do I want to do with you? I need to bring it down more. Remember. You're probably should have a little more wood to you. A little more, I think. Just hiding out up there. That's a pretty straight line, though. Pretty straight. She's sitting in there cockeyed. Got that much to get out. I think that has to be the bottom of her. Oh, I hate putting tenons on this side. Or mortises. Or any of the above. Maybe I put something down on this side, flip her around, and do her bottom. Maybe, because it looks like a lot of epoxy's got to go off the top of her. Can't. That may end up being the bottom. Well, only one way to tell is get some of this epoxy off of here, right? Ugh, such a waste. All right. Do you want a foot that big? Is it okay to have a foot that big? Huh? Is it? I don't like that part. But I may not have a choice in that part. What do you do? What do you do about that? I don't want to lose this. I don't want to lose that. I'm googly. I like all this. Two, I'll get rid of that. But they'll have that on the bottom and that on the bottom. Depending on how deep I go. What kind of a foot do you want? Maybe a little bit more? Maybe. Alright, do a little bit more. Do a little bit more around the curb. Don't get rid of that, though. No. Don't do it. Got it. You gotta do that. Alright. Okay.
Better not be tearing it up. Yeah. Got her in a lot better than I wanted to. Yay. Right close to it. Man, that was tearing that up.
Thank you.
remember if we've got any good here.
Chuck back. Let me see. I got a couple little bitty cracks down in there. Was that a crack? No? No? Okay, I'm a little bit concerned about CA. What you wobbling? Some CA staining. So, I am going to put some sanding sealer around that. Because I got a little crack here, a little crack there, and a couple little things there. So, we're going to do that. I know she's got to dry out a little bit from it, but I think that'll also help.
In the garage, she's going to be pretty. I can't stand it.
Gonna be pretty. Gonna be really cool looking green. If I can get her sanded up and polished up right. And don't throw her off the lathe and all that good business. I'm gonna let that dry. I think I'm just gonna use the clear CA. Okay. About continue to turn it. But then I'd have pretty thin little bottom. And I don't like to have my epoxy pieces too awful thin. Put some sanding sealer on her. That's the only thing I can think to do right now. Her cleaned up nice and good. Now we'll try some Yorkshire grit and all that business. I sure would like to go to bed. It's a little bit after midnight. Maybe a lot bit after midnight. But okay. Let's get my cell wool out. Give her a quick spin up. Thank you. How you doing, Reddy?
Huh? How you doing, the kitty cat? Sitting over there on my workbench? Yeah. Let's get on with the microfine, Yorkshire Red. Okay, let's get her going. Maybe I can go to bed sometime today. Maybe. What we got? We got a, not sure what kind of burl. It's definitely got the burl eyes. And there's some beautiful chatoyants and with the eyes. Hope you guys can see that. We mixed it with some blue and pearl. The grain in this is just gorgeous. Look at the bottom. Bottom's got a lot of chatoyants in it. And inside of her makes me think of a map for some reason. I don't know why. It does. Has some spalting in it. Just the grain. So much to look at. Some spalting over here. You know, the pearl didn't show up too well. But it's still pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it. So, well, I want to tell you guys thanks. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks for subscribing and sharing and caring. Anyway, thank you for commenting on the videos that I've done in the past. And thanks for my future comments. And, yeah. Tell me what you think of this. If somebody happens to know what kind of burl this is, I would love to know. The place I bought it from didn't have a clue. They just knew it was burl. You could tell. Anyway, yeah. So don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. It's fairly easy. You just push the subscribe button, and then if you push the little bell underneath it, it will let you know when my next video is coming out. So, anyway, you guys have a great week, and we'll see you next week.